Welcome back, everyone. I'm Rin, and this is part 2 of our 3D popping popcorn animation series. In today's video, I will dive deeper into texturing the pan and making the thrilling popping animation using Plane Effector and Cloner in Cinema 4D and Octane. I will continue by making the pan material. Create an Octane material. Change the material type to metallic. Add an octane noise node and connect to the diffuse map. Assign materials to objects to see the results. Click texture projection to adjust the material size. Change from mesh UV to XYZ to UVW. Create another octane noise node by copying. Then assign it to the bump map. And adjust the parameters. Maybe I should reduce power noise. Next, I will use Cloner. Put the kernel in Cloner. In the count section, I will set it to 8 and 8. And reduce the size to 10 and 10. To give these popcorn kernels a more natural arrangement, I will add a random effector in MoGraph. I want to adjust the rotation. Position. Pull them up a little bit, right click on Cloner, and assign it to the rigid body, and assign iron cast to collider body. Now I add the plane effector from the MoGraph menu. In the parameter tab, select scale, uniform scale, and set scale to 0.1. Then I create particles emitter. Rotate it 90 degrees and face down. Pull it up a bit. Now back to the plane effector. Open the fields tab, drag and drop emitter here. Select particle object. Drag the popcorn model into the cloner to the bottom. In the emitters parameter tab, set modify clone value to 100%. Play it. But nothing has happened yet. Open the object tab in cloner, and change the clone's type from iterate to sort. and try playing again. Okay, it has started working. Select emitter, and change the parameters in the particle tab. Oh, it's too much. Reduce the modify clone value a bit. Good. Return to the Fields tab of the plane effector. Change the radius value in the emitter's particle field layer to 20 centimeters. Hit play and see. Looks much better. But it seems a bit steady and slow. I want to have an explosion point near the end of the animation. So I'm going to create keyframes for radius. Try again. Yes, this is what I want. Now, I'm going to adjust the lighting a little bit. Maybe I should add a pan-shaking motion, putting everything in a null object, then assign vibrate tag, and set keyframe for it too. Okay, looks good. Finally, bake all simulation. And there it is, a satisfying 3D popcorn popping animation. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial series. Feel free to experiment, and remember, it is all about creativity and precision. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more exciting videos. Until next time.